Now, in order to find the velocity of SHM, we first of all consider the general equation of SHM, that is y is equal to a sine omega t or a cos omega t. So, when we say velocity, first of all we say y is equal to a sine omega t, where y is displacement, and a sine omega t means a is coefficient of sine omega t, so a will be known as the displacement amplitude. It is a vector quantity and it is associated with plus minus sign. When we write plus with a, it means amplitude is increasing. When we write negative sign with a, the amplitude is decreasing. So amplitude varies from positive to negative limits. So velocity of SHM means we have to take the derivative of displacement. So it will be dy over dt, and on the right side it should be a sine omega t. We take the derivative of that function. So this is what written now, which I have just now stated, that y is a sine omega t and a is the displacement amplitude and it is a vector quantity. Omega t is a phase angle and omega must be taken as 2 pi over t or 2 pi n. Now we know that velocity is rate of displacement. So velocity is given as dy over dt. So we have taken derivative of a sine omega t, which is found to be a omega cos omega t. Now here a omega is there. This is called velocity amplitude. This is also a vector quantity and this is also associated with plus minus sign. Now to find the velocity, what we will do, we have taken cos omega t as 1 minus sine square omega t under the root. Basically cos square omega t is 1 minus sine square omega t, then we take square root and we find the value of cos omega t. So velocity is a omega under the root 1 minus sine square omega t. Now sine is known to us, that is sine will be y over a. So the formula we have written, a omega under root 1 minus y square over a square. So velocity will be taken as, that is a square minus y square divided by a square, and taking a square outside the root sign and cancel with a. So our net expression for velocity of harmonic oscillator is omega under root a square minus y square, where a is the amplitude and y is the displacement. Now if suppose we wanted to find velocity at the mean position, so when we wanted to find velocity at the mean position, y will be taken as 0 and the function will become omega a, and omega a is nothing, it is basically velocity amplitude. But suppose that we wanted to find velocity for a maximum displacement, so for maximum displacement a square will be taken as y square, and y square will cancel off and it will become 0. So velocity at the extreme position will become 0. So these principles we apply in the various calculations. Now points regarding the velocity. Velocity will be maximum when displacement is 0, that is mean position. This I have just now explained, and velocity at mean position is a omega, and a omega is known as, that is velocity amplitude. Omega can always be replaced by 2 pi over f, 2 pi f or 2 pi over t. Velocity will be minimum when x will be plus minus a, that is at the position of maximum displacement. Minimum v is 0. Velocity is always ahead of the displacement by a phase angle of pi by 2. So velocity is ahead of displacement and acceleration is ahead of velocity by pi by 2. So acceleration is ahead of displacement by pi by 2 plus pi by 2, that is pi. Now the graph between displacement and velocity is ellipse. So this is the general equation given. Omega is 1, the curve would be a circle. Now acceleration of SHM. we have taken a function y is equal to a sine omega t, that is the displacement equation. Then we have taken derivative of displacement and that will become velocity. Whatever function we get for velocity, we have to take the derivative of velocity. So derivative of velocity we have to calculate, and that will be the acceleration in SHM. So v is taken as dy over dt, that is a omega cos omega t. Then we find acceleration a, that is dv over dt, or it is d square y over dt square, that is two derivatives of displacement or double derivative of displacement. So we take the displacement, that is we take the derivative of a omega cos omega t, and now it will be found as a omega square sine omega t. So what exactly we have done? A omega is taken out as a constant, and we have taken derivative of cos omega t, that is sine omega t. And then we have taken the derivative of omega t, and that will be omega. That's why the net result will become minus a omega square sine omega t. Wherever we write omega, that will be taken as 2 pi over t or 2 pi n, that is the frequency. So acceleration can be written as minus a omega square y over a. What we have done? We have multiplied and divided by a, and our result will become minus omega square y. Negative sign indicate that a and y are in opposite direction. Y is away from the mean position and a is directed towards the mean position. So a is equal to minus y. Now special note regarding acceleration, it is the rate of change of velocity. So acceleration will be maximum when x is plus minus a, that is f maximum equal to omega square a towards mean position. Acceleration will be minimum when x is 0, that is f minimum is 0. Acceleration is always ahead of the displacement by pi, as I have explained earlier, that is opposite to displacement. Acceleration leads the velocity by an angle pi by 2, and velocity leads the displacement by pi over 2, and the net leading of acceleration with respect to displacement is pi over 2, adding to it pi over 2, and that will become pi. The graph between acceleration and displacement will be a straight line which passes through the origin and has a slope negative of omega square. Omega is 2 pi f, so if we take the square, it is 4 pi square f square, and omega can also be taken as, that is 2 pi over t. The graph between velocity and acceleration is an ellipse if omega is 1, then the graph is in the form of circle.